Hello and welcome back. Today's video is going to be all about Ulta bestsellers that I have tried, my thoughts on them, and if I think that they are worth it or not. Last week I did this video for Sephora bestsellers, my thoughts on the ones that I've tried, so I will link that in the description box if you're interested in seeing that. This one is a bit more exciting because there's drugstore and high-end in here, because obviously that's what Ulta sells, so it's a bit more fun, I think. And yeah, I'm gonna tell you about the ones that I've tried, my thoughts. Let us know which of these you have tried, and let's get into it. No surprise that Tarte Shape Tape is listed as a bestseller. This is a very popular concealer, and I've actually finished two of these before. I do like it. I think it's a really nice concealer. It is very full coverage. I only used it on the under eye, and you only need a small amount. It's not too drying, at least for me, and I do have dry under eyes. However, I have really good drugstore concealers right now in my collection. The CoverGirl and the Milani are my two favorites. So I don't know that I feel the need for a high-end concealer, but I did like Tarte Shape Tape. Next up is the Original Smashbox Primer, and I do love this. I have finished several of those in the past. It's a favorite. It's kind of a classic clear pore-filling silicone primer. I like that though, because my biggest problem is my foundation sinking into my lines and my pores. So this is the type of primer that works for me. It's pretty basic though, and now I feel like there are some like that at the drugstore, and I have other primers that I like. I would repurchase it at some point, and I do think it's a really good primer. The next one is also a primer, and that is the Becca Backlight Priming Filter. This is $39, and this one I've tried and I did not love it. It is an illuminating primer. Funny though, it kind of adds like a sheen, but it doesn't add any moisture. It actually made my skin look more dry, and it definitely accentuated lines and pores. Therefore, this one is not for me. I don't know. I think this would be good for someone who doesn't really have problems with too dry of skin, too oily of skin, large pores, just kind of regular skin. But yeah, for me, I did not like it. The next item is this Pure Powder. This is the 4-in-1 Pressed Mineral Makeup with SPF 15. My color is light. This was sent to me from Pure and Octoly for a review. And this is $29, which is kind of expensive for a face powder, considering I have ones from the drugstore that I like. However, this is a really nice powder. It does add some coverage, but it's not too dry. It's not too cakey. Like I said, I have combo skin, and this is nice. I do really like it. It's kind of expensive, so I don't know that I would repurchase it, like I said, because I have drugstore ones that I like, but if you don't mind paying the $29, this is really nice. This next item, I am not surprised it's on this list because it's super popular. It's the Buxom Lip Glosses. They are $21, and I have purchased and finished quite a few of these, which is kind of strange considering I don't love them. However, I think the reason I kept buying them and using them up is because I love the way they look on the lips. They give a lot of shine, and I love shiny lip gloss. They're just a bit too tingly for me. My lips are kind of sensitive, or I'm a total wimp, I don't know, but it just feels like too much on my lips, and it is uncomfortable. I have had some other lip glosses, like right now I have one of those ColourPop ones in the tube. That has a bit of a tingling sensation, but it's much more mild and it doesn't bother me. But I'm honestly kind of sad that the Buxom ones are too much for me, because again, I love the way they look. And I have finished at least 3 or 4 of them, which is kind of weird that I kept buying them, but they just do look nice. So this kind of depends. I think if you don't mind that tingling feeling and you like a shiny lip gloss, you're definitely gonna like these. They are a bit sticky, but that does kind of help them last a bit longer. They're nice lip glosses, honestly, and maybe I'll try one out again. It's been a few years since I've tried one. But yeah, they do look quite nice. Next up are two products from Anastasia. No surprise here, the Brow Wiz and the Brow Pomade are on this list. And I actually do have the Brow Pomade. I forgot to grab it. But the Brow Wiz is $23 and the Pomade is $21. I used to go through the Brow Wiz like water. I used to use it every single day, and I could finish one in 2 months, which is very, very quick, especially at $23. But the main reason I stopped using it was because I just noticed brow pencils in general, maybe I'm pushing too hard on my brows with a brow pencil, but they tend to pull my hairs out. And since I've switched to either using powder or pomade, you just hardly have to apply any pressure at all, and you're using a brush, not like a pointy pencil. My brow hairs have actually grown in thicker since I stopped using pencils. Therefore, that's why I stopped using that. The brow pomade I really like, though. You have to be very light-handed. It is super, super pigmented. And funny enough to me, the price difference is absurd. That the fact that the pomade, which could last you years, I had one that lasted me like 2.5 years and I used it every day. It's $2 cheaper than the Brow Wiz, which I can fly through in 2 months. A little strange on that pricing, but anyway, overall, they are both good products, but I just prefer pomade or powder. Next up is an eyeshadow palette, and if you saw my recent declutter, you would have seen that I just got rid of this palette. It's the Tartlet in Bloom. It is $39, and I really do like this palette. I did not get rid of it because I don't like it. I got rid of it because it was my Pan That palette in 2018. I used it so much, and I used it every single day for a year, and I just stopped reaching for it because I was a little burned out on it, to be honest, but it is a beautiful palette. There's a lot of neutral shades, some cool tone shades. It's very pretty. I don't know that it's that revolutionary, though, honestly. I think I have the Milani Soft and Sultry palette now, which kind of has some similar shades. Not exact. It's not, I wouldn't say an exact dupe, but you can get some similar looks. And I kind of like the Milani formula better than the Tarte formula, which is kind of crazy. So I think if you got the Tartlet in Bloom, you would like it. I mean, a lot of people have it. It's a super popular palette, but I have found formulas I like better than Tarte. This next product I was very excited to see as a bestseller because I feel like nobody talks about these, at least not on YouTube, but obviously people are still buying these. These are the NYX Butter Glosses. They're $5. They used to be $4. I've noticed looking at this, a couple of things have gone up in price lately, but anyway, I love these. These are some of my favorite lip glosses. I've been using these for 10 years and they are fantastic. This color is Apple Strudel. They add some color, not a crazy amount of color, but they're quite shiny. They're a little sticky, but not too sticky. It's just really, really nice. Some of my favorite glosses. I think I have 3 or 4 of these. And I also have an Intense Butter Gloss. That's actually what I'm wearing right now. The Intense Butter Gloss and Peanut Brittle over a lipstick I'm gonna show you. And those are very nice and smooth. And those are very similar, but they're a bit more pigmented. I think they are both fantastic and a great price. No surprise that the Kylie lip products are listed as a bestseller because I'm pretty sure Ulta is the only store you can get them in. And I didn't even try Kylie until it came to Ulta just because I wanted to have the option to return the products because I didn't know how it was gonna work out. But I actually like what I've tried. This is the Velvet Lip. These are $16. This is the color Bare, and I'm wearing this today under that butter gloss. I mean, it's just a nude. It's really not like a revolutionary color. However, I really like this formula. I actually would buy more of these. I thought it was gonna be like the ColourPop Ultra Satin Lips, and it's not. I actually prefer this over that. The Ultra Satin Lips were a bit thick. They're both similar in that they're lipsticks that liquid lipsticks that do not dry down matte. They're not transfer proof like, you know, the ultra matte lips, for example. They are very comfortable. I do wear a lip gloss on top. That's just what I prefer, but they're not as thick and kind of sticky as the ColourPop ones. It's a very thin formula, therefore it's more comfortable, but it is very pigmented. Like I said, I'm wearing this with that lip gloss on top. This is a really nice formula. $16, a little steep, but it's not crazy. Considering how much I like this, I actually would purchase more. Another lipstick were the Urban Decay lipsticks. And I have the color 1993, which is a comfort matte. This is probably one of their most well-known shades. It's like a brownish color. I don't know. The formula is fine. It's not bad, but I mostly just keep this around because I don't have any other colors like this. I actually prefer the ColourPop Luxe lipsticks as far as tube lipsticks go. So price-wise, I don't know that this is worth it for the formula, but I think if there's a more unique color, because they have a huge range of this. They have tons and tons of shades. That's what I like about it. And when I was looking for a color like this, I couldn't really find one in another brand. At least this was a few years ago. I've had this lipstick for a while. It's a really pretty brown. So I would say if you want a unique color and they're the only ones that have it, it is a nice formula. The Comfort Matte, it's matte, not too drying. It's comfortable, you know, it's all in the name. But they do have other formulas. You know, they have one with a shimmer, one that's more creamy. I don't have any of those, but I like this. I just, you know, I have cheaper lipsticks that are just as good, if not better. This is one I was kind of surprised to see as a bestseller. This is the Sugar Glow Kit. I feel like people don't really talk about these Anastasia Glow Kits anymore, but I love them. This is probably one of my favorite highlighter formulas. This one has some really nice colors. All of these shades work for my skin tone. You know, this one has some pink in it. This is more of a bronze, kind of like a light yellow gold. I love it. It's a very metallic formula. There are some glitter particles in here, so if you don't want any glitter in your highlighter, I don't think you would like this. But yeah, I see these on sale all the time. This one and the Sun Dipped. And yeah, I think they're fantastic. I think nowadays people are kind of getting over the whole highlighter palette thing because it is a little bit unnecessary. Often there will be a color that, you know, maybe too light or too dark for you, but you like a different color. So all in all, it probably makes more sense to buy individual highlighters. But this one I love because every color does work for me and it is a fantastic formula. So I do think this is worth it in my opinion. On to more drugstore. And again, I'm not surprised is on this. This is the e.l.f. Putty Primer. This has gotten a lot of hype in the last several months. And I talked about this in a recent haul update. I do really like this primer. I'm wearing it today. It is one where you have to stick your finger in there and kind of smear it on your face. But I think if you want one of these primers that is good for filling in lines and pores, this does do that. And yeah, it's good. It really is. It's very similar to the Tatcha one, which I also own. And I did mention in that video that they are nearly identical and I almost prefer this, but there isn't a whole lot of difference between them. This one may actually be a bit less drying. Yeah, I think this is good, but I don't know that these are better than other pore filling primers. I think it was just kind of like a unique format, something different, so it got a lot of hype. It is good, but, you know, and I know a lot of people wouldn't like to be sticking their finger in it for, you know, sanitary reasons. I don't mind because I always wash my hands before I put my makeup on, so it's not that big of a deal, but honestly, a tube or a bottle, it's more practical. I mean, now that I've had these two primers, I'll use them, but I don't know that I would repurchase this type of primer. No surprise on the next one, and that is the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. This is $16. Some of these drugstore prices obviously vary if you're not buying it at Ulta, because I feel like the Butter Bronzer is a couple dollars cheaper at Target. Anyway, I had the original one, and I've actually finished two of these. It's a really nice bronzer. It just blends in so easily. I really miss it. I've been considering repurchasing it, but again, I don't really need it. So hard to say, but I do love it. And like I said, I finished two of them in the past. My only gripe about this product is the packaging. They have that underneath part where they have a brush that it's like most people don't use that brush. I know I didn't. And then the clasp on both of mine broke within a month. And a lot of other people I've seen, the clasp breaks pretty quickly. You know, even if you don't drop it or anything, I did not drop it. So that's a little frustrating. $16 is a bit steep for drugstore prices in my opinion, but it is a great bronzer. The next item is the Juvia's Place I Am Magic Foundation. This is $20 and I bought this and I returned it. It is just not for me. It was one of the worst foundations I've ever tried. It made my face look 100 years old. It sunk in so badly to the lines on my forehead and it just was so cakey. Even if I put a small amount on, this is really intense coverage. So I think if you want the most intense full coverage foundation the world has ever seen, in my opinion, this is it, but it was so unflattering on me. I looked 100 years old. I returned it. I couldn't make it work. I tried it on 3 different days and every day it looked awful. I could not believe it. I know this does have some good reviews, so I think if you have like really smooth skin with no lines and no pores, you may like this, but for me, it was unflattering. It made me look worse. So yeah, not worth it. Two left. This is the Too Faced Bronzer. This is $30. This is the original Chocolate Soleil that I have and pretty standard bronzer. I have finished one of these before though. This is my second one. I really do like it. This one, it's hard to tell, but this one leans a bit more neutral, which is kind of nice. It's not too cool, not too warm. I actually really enjoy this as a contour shade for me. That works very nice, but it also works as an all-over bronzer. And it smells like chocolate. You know, I think nowadays you can get such good bronzers at the drugstore. I know e.l.f. has one that people rave about. I have not tried it. And also the Physician's Formula. But if you don't mind spending the $30, this is really good. I actually got this at the 21 Days of Beauty last year when it was on sale for, I think, $15, which is 50% off. So keep an eye out for the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty because some of these kind of cult classics, like this bronzer, are often on sale during that. And that usually happens sometime in March. So I'm excited to see what's in the 21 Days of Beauty this year. But anyway, I do like this. I don't know if it's worth $30, but it's good. Last up is the Bare Minerals Mineral Veil. This is $25, and this is my holy grail under eye powder. It has a pink tint to it, as you can tell. Even though I have yellow undertones, I do like to use a pink powder under my eyes. I feel like it kind of contrasts darkness, or at least that's what an employee told me at MAC like 10 years ago, and I've still been doing that. So it works for me. I like it. And this is very finely milled. I really like this powder because of the color. Those white kind of powders always leave me a white cast. I look like Casper the Friendly Ghost when I use those on my under eye, so no go on those. The thing about this is I have a lot of lines under my eyes, and if I don't use this, if I use another powder, my concealer creases. Something about this keeps the concealer from creasing. It's like magic. I don't know what's in it. I think it's just that it's such a finely milled, like mineral powder. I think a lot of other powders, they're not quite this finely milled, but anyway, this works. And for me, this is a holy grail. I know a lot of people set their whole face with this. I don't do that because of the pink color. I think that would throw my foundation off, but I really enjoy this for the under eyes. Alrighty, that is it for the Ulta bestsellers that I have tried. There are a lot more though, because Ulta sells so many products. Drugstore, high-end, you know, they kind of have it all. Therefore, I've tried a lot more than even this, but this is kind of the main ones that I noted on the page. Let us know, have you tried any of these products? That is it, and thank you so much for watching.